Amen.
Good morning and welcome to the online worship services of the Mount Zion Primitive Baptist Church, located
Let's
at
this choir sing this morning,
Highway,
y'all.
Where our pastors, Elder Dr. Malmer Burwell. We are so thankful that you've chosen to worship with us this morning. We are excited to have you in our presence. We pray that you have a blessed worship experience. Enjoy.
In the name of Jesus, who is our Christ, I am thankful always for the privilege of priest time. Amen. Get a chance to say something about our Lord. Amen. God bless you this morning. I pray the Lord will bless you and certainly he will keep blessing you. My Bible is open to that 63rd Psalm that the Reverend Pride read to this morning. Psalm 63. Psalm 63. I believe you read the first five verses. Let's pick up at verse 6. When I remember thee on my bed, I meditate on thee in the night and watches, and thou hast been my help. In the shadow of thy wings, I sing of thy joy. My soul clings to thee, my right hand upon thee. But those who seek my life to destroy it will go in the depth of the earth. They will deliver over the power of the sword, and they will pray of the foxes, and the king should rejoice in God. Everyone who swears by him will glory, for the mouth of those who speak lies will be stopped. I thought to talk just a few minutes this morning from pursuing God with thirsty hearts.
Amen.
Pursuing God with thirsty hearts. This 63rd Psalm is a song of David in despair. When you get some time, I would that you would take a moment to peruse it and look at it in depth, and you'll find that never does David say to God, Lord, where were you when I needed you? you won't find anywhere. Now, Lord, come on and take me out right now. Instead, what David does is he decides to pray and to praise in his difficult moment.
That's right.
I thought we ought to seek God with thirsty hearts.
Yes, sir.
If I had to pick a word, I think, to describe our world today, I think that word would be disconnected. Or maybe under stress. It seems that everywhere we turn, there is a disconnect. Or there is something that is stressing us out. Something that keeps us from coming together. And so many people are at their wit's end trying to figure out, what must I do now? I heard in Reverend Malone's prayer that the election didn't end the way some of us wanted it to end. And so many folk are destroyed in dismay, wondering, where was God? God is in charge.
That's right. He's
in the same place he was the day before the election. He didn't lose any power. Disconnects and stress seems to follow us in whatever we try to do. Somebody's team didn't win last night. They're stressed by it. Somebody's child is not doing as well as they could do in school, and they're stressed by it. Somebody's job and their career is not taking off like it should, and they're stressed by it. And some folk, God has blessed them so much until they can't sleep, they worrying how to keep what they got.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Trying to keep other folk from getting what they got. I tell you, this world brings us to places where there's a disconnect. And we have to figure out how to seek God with thirsty hearts. We have to know when to call him and how to call him.
Yes,
sir. We must keep our mind and our focus on God.
Yes, sir.
We have to make sure that our God lives are focused on him who can help us and him who is able to give us what we need. That's what I want to talk about, pursuing God with thirsty hearts. King David is a writer this morning in this passage of scripture. He is king of Israel. He has a high responsibility in the position of leading the people of God. But yet he finds himself in great distress. He has problems because his boy Absalom has led a rebellion against him. And some of the followers that used to follow King David are now following Absalom. And they have made him flee from his kingdom. Flee across the Jordan into a barren land. And there in a barren land with just a few folk, he's feeling disgraced and rejected. Uncertain. And so he gives to us his thoughts and his prayers in Psalm 63. Oh, bless God for this psalm.
Amen.
Many of us have been in like wilderness that David is in. We needed to know what to do when it seemed like our world was coming in on us.
That's right.
Yes, sir.
We needed somebody to tell us that that we need to really seek God with a thirsty heart. Seek him that in a time that you just can't get enough of him. They will tell us in a minute that I'm satisfied with Jesus, but but I ain't satisfied.
Yes, sir.
I want more. Sometimes we get to the place in our spiritual walk with God that we become complacent and we decide that I got all of Jesus that I need. That's a bad place to be. We always need more of him.
That's right.
Our goal is to be like him. We cannot fully understand who he is in this frame that we live in now. Because inside this frame, there's things pulling at us. There's evil pulling at us. Every time I try to do good,
come on now,
evil is present.
That's right. Yes, sir.
When I have a good thought, so long as my mind tracks a bad thought.
That's right.
I wonder why I do the stuff that I do.
Yes, sir.
Why I say words that I say. Why I act like I act.
Come on now.
Paul said there's two of me. That's the one of me that's been born again, the one of me that walks in the Spirit of God, and then there's the natural man. And the natural man, they're fighting for position. They're fighting for control. And you have to feed them. You can feed the natural man with foolishness, hatred, envy, anger, frustration. Or you can feed the godly man with humility, love, joy, and peace.
Yes, sir.
That's right.
Preach that.
But we must have pursuit in our heart. We must pursue God.
Yes, sir.
He wants us to pursue him. David talks to us, and I'm going to lift up three things. I'm going to hurry to my chair. First thing is, what does it look like when you're seeking God? What does it look like when you're seeking God? This text really is an easy chapter. Verses 1 through 4 talks about God is my desire. David said, he's all I need. Verse 5 through 8 talks about the fact that God is my delight. I delight in him. Verses 9 through 11 says, God is my defense. He'll help me in everything I need. We must realize that God wants us to be a seeker after him.
That's right.
Look what he said. Let me hear it. He says, oh God, thou art my God. He's saying, I know him, but the only way I'm going to get to know him better is I got to have a relationship with him.
That's right.
He says, I seek thee earnestly. Yes, I know God, but I got to keep spending time with God.
That's right.
Every day I must spend some time with him. I got to keep asking him, Lord, show me more and more of who you are. That's what he's saying. To seek God is to desire him. You see it. He says, seek him earnestly. You got to do more than pray on Sunday.
That's right.
You got to do more than pray when you eat. He says, seek him earnestly. I got to desire him. I got to think on him when I'm moving, when I'm laying down, when I'm resting. I got to think on him. I got to declare, I need you, Lord, in everything I do.
That's right.
can't make it by myself. When you play with that word, earnest, it says early, dawn. It says diligently. I got to seek him always.
Yes, sir.
I can't stop seeking him. When I'm hurting, I got to seek him.
That's right.
Yes, when I'm mourning, I got to seek him. Yes. When I got a lot of friends, I got to seek him. Uh-huh. When I'm friendless, I got to seek him. When the world seems to be at my back, I got to seek him. He's saying I got to seek him always.
Yes, sir.
Sometimes we get so blessed by God. That we forget to seek God.
Tell the truth.
We have to seek him all the time.
Yes, sir.
With thirsty hearts.
That's right.
We have to ask him to fill the vacuums in our lives.
That's right.
That are empty. David had a throne. He had been run out of his kingdom. His son wanted to kill him. But you don't find him praying, give me my throne back.
That's right.
You don't find him praying, let me have my robe back.
Uh-huh.
You don't find him praying, Lord, let me be able to sit there at the long table.
Mm-hmm.
Yet he says,
Oh my God,
I shall seek thee earnestly. Can I come on and tell you, we got to seek God earnestly,
yes, sir.
Unconditionally. His love has to be the order of our day.
Yeah.
We got to want him more than anything in life.
That's right.
We have to seek God, I tell you. That's what he wants us to do.
That's right.
I thought about Moses. Went up on the mountain. While he was up there, he stayed there for 40 days.
Uh-huh.
And while he was up there with God, the Bible said he came down. And his face was shining.
That's right.
Bible says his face was radiating with glory.
That's right.
Because he had a visible sign that he had been seeking God.
Yeah.
I tell you, brothers and sisters, when you see God, ought to be a visible sign.
Uh-huh.
Somebody ought to know been with the Lord.
Yes, sir.
Either in the way you walk,
yes, sir.
Or the way you talk.
Yes, sir.
Somebody just ought to know you spend some time with God.
Preach that.
Yes, sir. Seeking God. I thought about Paul and Silas.
Uh-huh.
Paul and Silas were in jail.
Uh-huh.
And they took them to the center of jail. They put chains on their feet and on their hands. And while they were in jail, Bible said about midnight. Yeah, they started to cry out in praise.
Yeah.
Can't you hear them in chains crying to God? Can't you hear them praising and praising the Lord? You know you got to see God no matter what's going on with you. The Bible said while they were praising God, earthquake came. Ain't God all right? Then shook the prison, doors come open. Ain't God good, y'all? You got to seek God. Seek him. Seek him. If you seek God, he will show up.
That's right.
Yes, we ought to be seekers of God.
That's right.
Well, not only must we be seekers of God, but I tell you, the Bible says, what does it look like? When you're seeking God, there it is. It's in the text. Look at it. It says in verse 3, he praised God with his lips. You see it, don't you?
Uh-huh.
It's love kindness better than life.
Yes, sir.
My lips will praise him.
Uh-huh.
Look at verse 4. Verse 4 says, I praise him with my hands.
Yeah.
You see it there, don't you? I lifted my hands. Look at verse 5. Verse 5 says, I praise him with my mouth. You see it there, don't you? Verse 6 says, I praise him with my memory. I meditated on him. Ain't God good, y'all? All I'm trying to tell you, if God been good to you every now and then, you ought to show some sign. Ain't God all right? If God brought you from a mighty long way, every now and then, you ought to clap your hand, wave your hand, every now and then, somebody ought to know. Somebody ought to know you didn't bring yourself. I don't understand how God can be good to you and you don't never move. I don't understand how God can keep you and you don't never say thank you. I don't understand how you can always be so still and God got you in his hand. Seem like to me every now and then at the red light, you ought to let the steering wheel go and tell the Lord, oh Lord, I sure do thank you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Seem that way to me. Seem that way to me.
That's right.
David says, I sought him from an infinite perspective. David says, my soul is satisfied to the marrow of the fatness. David says he's so deep, got all in the bone, got all in the marrow of my bone. He said, I'm satisfied. Yes, sir. He says, I got joy on the inside. Look at it. Verse 5 says, I got inner joy.
Yeah.
Verse 7 says, I got joy.
Joy.
Verse 11 says, I got joy.
Joy.
Y'all hear me? Every now and then, joy will run over sometime.
Yes,
ain't going all right. Every now and then, you just let me be able to hold it.
Yeah.
Ain't going all right. Every now and then, somebody on the outside ought to know I've been bought with a price. Somebody ought to know I'm rooted and I'm grounded. Somebody ought to know I'm wrapped and I'm tied. I belong to God. Ain't God good? Ain't God good? Yes, ain't God good? The Bible says,
yes, sir.
The person who got God has stability. That is in verse 7. You see that, don't you? He says, in the shadow of the wings, he said, I'll sing for joy.
Yes, sir.
You see it there, don't you?
Uh-huh.
It's ought to be something in you that just won't let you leave this thing alone. Yes. When you got Jesus, ought to be a pursuit going on. Well, I'm on hurry, but I thought about the woman that had an issue of blood.
Yes.
You remember, don't you?
Yes, sir.
Spent all the money.
Uh-huh.
Yes, sir. Couldn't go outside. Outcast. But somebody told her Jesus was coming by.
Yes, sir.
I saw in my spirit. I saw in my heart, fighting the crowd. Look at her. Excuse me, sir. Pardon me, ma'am. Excuse me, sir. Pardon me, ma'am. Ain't God good? Ought to do all you can to get to Jesus. Ain't God all right? The Bible said that when she got to him, she touched the hem of his garment. Ain't God good? Ain't God good, y'all? Yes, the Lord, he is good. Ain't God all right? I heard the Lord said, somebody touched me. Ain't God all right?
Breathe. Yes. Breathe.
Bible said, when you touched him,
yes, sir.
Blood
uh-huh.
stopped flowing.
Yes, sir.
Ain't God all right?
Yeah.
when your testimony dried up. Ain't going good.
That's right.
You got to pursue God earnestly.
Uh-huh.
Yes, sir. With a thirsty heart. Yes, sir. Well, I thought again about the woman that was a widow. She persistently kept on calling on the judge. She kept on seeking justice. Just kept on calling him. Just kept on begging him.
Yes,
I heard the Lord say, this woman is faithful. Ain't going good.
Yes.
I know what you ought to do when you're broke. Ought to keep on going to God. Lord, I know I told you yesterday, but I'm still broke, God, and I need your help. When you're sick, ought to keep on going to God. Lord, I know I told you yesterday, but I'm still sick. Ain't God good? Ain't God all right? Oh, when you told the Lord, Lord, my heart broke. Ought to keep on telling the Lord, I told you yesterday, ain't God all right? Yes, have to keep on calling God. He'll open doors for you. Won't God open doors? He'll make a way out of no way. Ain't God good? Ain't God good? Do y'all know Jesus? Do y'all know him? Do y'all really know him? Ain't God good?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to my chair. I'm going to my chair.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'm going to my chair. One more thing. He said, how does a person seek after him? It's right to seek him.
Yes, sir.
We ought to seek him.
Yes, sir.
But how do I seek after him?
Uh-huh.
What must I do to seek after God?
Yes, sir.
There it is. In verse 8, I'm going to my chair.
Come on,
he says, my soul,
yes, sir,
clings to thee. My right hand upholds thee. Yes, I'm going to call the Lord, and then I'm going to trust him. I can't do nothing on my own. I'm going to trust God when I can't see him working. I'm going to trust him when I don't feel like nothing happening. I'm still going to trust him. He's all I have. I don't have nothing else. He's God. All by himself. Wait a minute. I'm going to my chair, y'all. But come here, Daniel. Daniel said, as the decree went out, the decree said, I can't pray. The decree said, I can't pray to nobody. If I get caught praying, they're going to put me in the lion's den. It got all right. But Daniel said, I can't help it. I can't help it. The Bible says, every day, at the same time, Daniel went to his window and opened up his window and began to pray to God. Ain't God good? Ain't God good? The Bible said the king, he got old Daniel. Yes, sir, Daniel, didn't I tell you you couldn't pray and put old Daniel in the lion's den? Ain't God good? But my God, my God, my God, he know how to help his folk out. He know how to take care of things. The Bible said God shut the mouth of the lion, and old Daniel laid down on the lion. Ain't God good? Ain't God good? Won't God fight your battle? Won't God make a way for you? Ain't God good? Yes. I'm going to my chair now, y'all. I'm done. All I wanted to tell you is pursue God. That's all David was trying to tell us here in the verse. I know your heart is broken, but see God. I know you don't understand what's going on in our world, but see God. I thought I'd tell you, pray to him. Tell him, Lord, I don't understand, but I'm standing on you. I know you are able. You're going to work it out. Is that all right? Ain't God good? Yes, that's all Daniel. That's all David wanted to say. I'm finished. I'm going to my chair. Look ahead, y'all. You got to see God with a thirsty heart. I don't know when, Lord. I don't know how. I don't know how you're going to do it. But I know you're going to do it. I'm waiting on you to do it. Ain't God good? Somebody said, well, But well, how you gonna seek God that you don't know? How you gonna pray to him if you don't know him? You must, you got to know who he is. Old folks say you gotta be, you must be born again. Ain't going good, any good, y'all. Ain't going good. I'm going to my chair, but I need to tell you who he is. Y'all don't mind, do you? If I just take one more minute and talk about Jesus. Y'all do know him, don't you? Mary's baby, do y'all know him? Joanna's grandboy, do y'all know him? He's a wheel in the middle of a wheel. Do y'all know him? He's a horse pawing in the valley. Do y'all know him? He's a lily of the valley. Do y'all know him? He's Alpha and Omega. Do y'all know him? He's the first and the last. Ain't God good? He's my arthritis medicine in the bottle. Ain't God good? He's my headache medicine in the bottle. Ain't God good? Do y'all know him? Do you know him? He's peace in the valley. Ain't God good? He's my strength. Ain't God good? He's my hope, my peace. Ain't God good? Do y'all know him? One Friday on Calvary's Hill, they put nails in his hand. They stacked his feet on top of one another. They hung him high. They stretched him wide. Ain't God good? I know you know it, but he died. He died. He died. Didn't he die? But he did not stay dead. I wish y'all would help me. He didn't stay dead right early. Y'all ain't helping me right early. Why don't you help me early? Help me. Help me early. 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 He got out the grave. He's alive. He got alive. He's alive. He got alive. Yes. 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 He is alive. He is alive. He is alive. He is alive. I know he's alive. He talks with me. I know he's alive. He answers my prayers. He holds my hand. Ain't God good? Ain't he good? Yes. Yes. Oh, yeah. Yes. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yes, sir.
He's mine. He's mine. He's mine, and I'm his. Ain't God good? Ain't God good? Ain't God good, y'all? I done messed around, y'all, and got happy. Ain't God good? Ain't he good? Yes. Oh, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yes, sir. I'm glad I know him. 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 Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
I'm glad I.
It's all right.
I'm glad I know him.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
David says, seek God with a thirsty heart.
Yes, sir.
Pursue God. You got to want him.
That's right.
You got to desire him. You got to taste him.
Yes, sir.
Whatever's happening in your life, whatever's going on with you.
That's right.
Here's my request.
That's right.
Pursue God with a thirsty heart.
Yes, sir.
Don't ever get enough. Just keep on pursuing him.
That's right.
He'll mess around and fill your cup. Somebody say he'll make you run. Ain't nobody chasing you.
Yes, he will. Yes, he will.
That's right. That's right.
I just thought to tell you, pursue God.
Yeah.
Pursue God with a thirsty heart.
Yes,
let me offer you Christ. If you're able to stand, would you stand with me if you're able to stand?
Amen.
I invite you to come to Jesus. Right now. Would you pursue him? Do it now while the water's troubled.
That's right.
That's right.
Do it now. Do it right now. whosoever will, let him come. Maybe you're a member of Mount Zion and you strayed away. We invite you to come home today. Maybe you've never been baptized. You've had an experience with God. You thought about how it was him that kept you. All the years you've been here, you thought it was him who took care of you. You thought about how it was him that was made a way for you all this time. Why don't you come right now? Maybe you need a church home. We invite you to come. Come be a part of this fellowship. You need a covering. Why don't you come? Why don't you come? The Bible says, whosoever will, let them come. If you've never made him Lord of your life, we're going to pray for you right now. Would you bow with me right where you stand? Right where you stand. If you know somebody that's not saved, would you pray for them right now? If you're here and you're not saved, we're praying for you right now. Yes. That God will give you a heart to come to him. God's seeking you now. Why don't you seek him? Pray, church. Maybe it's a co-worker. Maybe it's a family member. Maybe it's a spouse. Pray. Pray, church.
Yes.
Pursue God with a thirsty heart. Why don't you come? Come while the blood still runs warm in your vein. Why don't you come right now? Well, God bless you. We pray the house to say thank you for your prayers. God bless you. Thank you for standing.
Sometimes it feels cold and you feel all alone. Hold on, better days are coming.
Oh, yeah.
world. I know it ain't easy, but hang on in there. I know better days are coming. You've seen good, you've seen bad, you've been happy and sad. But just remember the better days are coming. Friends will leave you all by yourself. But don't you cry, 'cause better days are coming. Help me say, better days. It's only a season, ooh, that you're going through. Yeah, yeah. Stay focused and never lose sight. I know people, don't see the hurt you feel inside. Keep on smiling, and everything will be all right. Better days, better days.
I may be sick now, but there's better days. Grieving now, but better days. Yeah, I don't feel good today, but better days. Yeah, there are better days coming. Bless God, amen. Help me bless God for the choir already, amen. It is offering time after you prepare your heart to give the Lord an offering. Ask that you bless the Lord according to how he has blessed you. Amen. When you give to him the way he has prospered you, then God is pleased. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. you're visiting with us, there's only one offering. We ask that you would give that offering. Ask that you would give as liberally as you can to our members this homecoming. Let's bless the Lord today.
Remembering the words the Lord Jesus Christ himself said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. It is tempting to always look for the return on an investment, a return on your generosity. And that is worthwhile because we must be excellent stewards of God's money. But sometimes generosity is more about what God is doing in us through our giving than it is about knowing exactly how that gift will be used. We are entering that moment right now in our worship service when we are all challenged once again to believe the promise of Jesus. It is more blessed to give than to receive. Will you join me this morning in trusting this promise by giving to our church? Remember, when we give, we become like Christ, for it's truly more blessed to give than to receive. You have multiple ways that you may be a blessing to your church this morning. You may go to our website and click on the blue Giblify button, or you may go directly to Giblify and search for the Mount Zion Primitive Baptist Church where you'll find our picture. You may mail your offering to 2350 Wall Triana Highway, Huntsville, Alabama, 35824. You may drive by and leave it in our mailbox at your convenience. Or if you're worshiping in house with us this morning, you may place your offering in the tray. For truly it is more blessed to give than to receive. We thank you for your generous offering. We thank you for allowing God to bless us through you. Be blessed.
Church say amen. Amen. Let church say amen again. Amen. Amen. I pray that everyone had a chance to give. Amen. Amen. Before we go into our offering prayer, we always like to ask, are there any prayer requests on our intercessory prayer? Are there any prayer requests this morning? Amen. She asked a special prayer for Travis. Anyone else? Johnny Harris and James Stone. Sister Bradley. Asking prayer for Sister Bradley. Mount Zion Church family. Sister Jardine Martin. Asking prayer for Sister McGowan. Always asking prayer for Sister McGowan. Amen.
Asking prayer for my niece up in New York. She'll be having surgery on Thursday.
Amen. Asking prayer for Brother Turner's niece. She's sir.
April Bowley.
Bowley or Poley? Bowley. April Bowley. Asking prayer. Asking prayer.
Gloria Raglan.
Gloria Raglan. Asking prayer for Gloria Raglan. Anyone else?
Also, remember Pastor Cole's family.
Amen. The Carter family. Amen. You know, church, we need to pray. Amen.
Amen.
In a couple of days, we're going to be going to vote. I implore, I encourage for you to go and vote. Amen?
Amen.
That is a privilege for all of us to go and vote. We look back and we see how our ancestors bled and died for us to have the right to vote. Amen? So I encourage us in a couple of days to go out and vote. Amen? I ask a special blessing on the Indian Creek Association. Amen? I ask that you build those churches up, those pastors, those members. Amen? I'm praying that someone in here will go out and tell somebody about a dead burial and risen Savior. Amen? Because if there was a time that we need to pray, the time is right now. Amen? So as Deacon Harris, as he prays for us this morning, I ask the church to pray with him. Pray for our children. Pray for our schools. Pray for our nation. We need to pray, y'all. Scripture says, pray without ceasing. And that means pray at all times, amen? Even when you're having good days. Amen? So as he prays, church, pray with him, because we need the Lord, not just on Sundays. We need him every day. Amen?
Amen.
Deacon Harris.
Most holy and everlasting Father, Father, we come calling on thee, my heavenly Father, because we have no other God to call on. Father, we come this morning just to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
The sleep we slept last night was not the sleep of death. Father, we thank thee for allowing us to come out to the house of worship one more time. Father, we come thanking thee, my heavenly Father, for everyone that sits around my voice. Father, we know you know all about them. Father, we know you know their needs and their wants. Father, we ask you to bless them as only you can. Father, we come, my heavenly Father, asking a special blessing upon the names that was called, my heavenly Father.
Yes, Jesus.
Father, we know you know all about them also. Father, we know there was some name that wasn't called, but you know all about them also, my heavenly Father. Father, we ask you just continue, hold your arms around them. Be everything that they need. Father, we come, my heavenly Father, and ask you to bless this church as a whole, my heavenly
yes,
Father.
Yes, Lord.
Bless the man you got over here to lead and guide us. Continue to hold him in the palm of your hand. Lead and guide him and direct his path. Father, bless his family. Not only him, my heavenly Father, but we ask a special blessing up on the man that can stand in the gateways today, my heavenly
yes,
Father.
Yes, Lord.
Continue to hold your arms around him. Lead him from one good degree to another. Father, not only him, but we ask you to bless your preached word all over your land and country.
Yes, Lord.
Father, we come asking a special blessing up on the one who don't know thee, my heavenly Father. Touch their heart, my heavenly Father. Take control of their mind. Let them know that one day they're going to need you. Not only that, my heavenly Father, but we ask you to bless this young generation, my heavenly Father. Father, continue to hold your arms around them. bless them, my Heavenly Father. Let them know, my Heavenly Father, that there's none like you. Father, we just want to say thank you, my Heavenly Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for being God and God all by yourself. Father, we thank you, my Heavenly Father, for friends. Father, we thank thee for enemies also. Father, we come, my Heavenly Father, bless this country as a whole, my Heavenly Father.
Yes,
bless
Lord.
The leaders. Take control of their mind. Let them know, my Heavenly Father, that you're still in control. Father, we just want to say thank you. Thank you for that little family of ours, my Heavenly Father. Continue holding us in the palm of your hand. Lead and God direct our path. Father, just able to hold on to your unchanging hand, my Heavenly Father. Father, we come, my Heavenly Father, and ask you to bless this offering, my Heavenly Father. Father, may it be used for the upbuilding of our kingdom. Father, we come asking these and all other in that darling son's name. Amen. We do thank you.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. If you prepare our hearts and the choir on the way now, let me do my part and then make presentation of our speaker this morning. Certainly, our speaker comes this morning to our way of grace. He is my friend, been friend a long, long time. I want to appreciate him. His lovely wife is with him this morning. He comes from Chattanooga, Tennessee. He is the Elder James Leslie, the Lord's preacher. I ask that you set yourself in a heart of praise and get Lord. Ask him to bless you as you come forward, as we start to meditate on the word of God. Our choirs will come and sing, as many songs they're going to sing, and then we'll have a word from our preacher. Would you receive him, James Leslie?
Sick.
charges. Yes, he dropped the charges. Jesus dropped the charges.
When he died on Calvary,
he dropped the charges.
Dropped the charges.
When he died for you and me,
dropped the charges.
Dropped the charges.
Dropped the charges.
Yeah.
Dropped the
charges.
He dropped the charges.